latest on Typhoon Hulyan, which is battering northern Luzon. Let's get an update now from ABS-CBN resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel, over to you.
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. Typhoon Hulyan has passed Sabtang Island in Batanes and is forecast to reach super typhoon strength this afternoon or evening, which may warrant raising of wind signal number 5 in Batanes. Hulyan will begin to recurve Tuesday and briefly exit the Philippine area of responsibility, re-enter and make landfall over southern Taiwan Wednesday afternoon or evening, and leave the country for good by Thursday. Currently, wind signal number 4 is hoisted over Batanes and Babuyan, northern Babuyan Islands. Signal number 3 over the rest of Babuyan and the northeastern mainland Cagayan. Signal number 2 is in effect over Ilocos Norte, Apayao, the rest of mainland Cagayan, and the northern portions of Ilocos Sur, Abra, and Kalinga. While the rest of Ilocos Sur, Abra, and Kalinga, La Union, Pangasinan, Benguet, Ifugao, Mountain Province, Isabela, Nueva Vizcaya, Quirino, Aurora, northern and eastern Nueva Ecija, and Polillo Islands remain under wind signal number 1. Violent winds and torrential rains will continue to batter Batanes and Babuyan Islands until later today, while strong winds and intense rains will affect the rest of northern Luzon, especially Ilocos Region, Western Cordillera, and Cagayan, as well as parts of central Luzon, including Zambales and Bataan. Serious flooding and landslides continue to threaten these areas. Meanwhile, the trough or extension of a typhoon will also bring gusty winds and occasional rains here in Metro Manila, Calabarzon, and parts of Maropa and Bicol. That's the latest on the weather. This is Ariel Rojas. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, our resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas there joining us live. Now, as Ariel reported there, Typhoon Hulyan is bringing heavy rains to northern Luzon. Our correspondent PJ Cabanos now joins us with the latest from there. PJ, go ahead.
The effects of Typhoon Hulyan are now being felt in the northern part of Cagayan. Footage from MDRMO Calayan shows strong winds and rain brought by Typhoon Hulyan in the area. In Clavera, Cagayan, the Kabikungan River has already overflowed and strong winds are also pounding the coastlines. According to a post from Cagayan Provincial Information Office, 828 individuals from 284 families have been evacuated due to typhoon. Preemptive evacuations have been carried out in 6 towns including Santa Praxedes, Gataran, Calayan, Pamplona, Gonzaga, and Santa Ana. Several towns have also declared class suspensions from preschool to college. In Santa Ana, Cagayan, a man was declared dead on arrival after being struck by a power line while riding a motorcycle. According to the investigation by the PNP Santa Ana, strong winds this morning caused the power line to sag and fall on Benjo Castren, a 26-year-old man who was driving. A hospital's examination confirmed that electrocution was the cause of his death. Meanwhile, a video taken by the resident Vincent Gabilo shows strong winds and heavy rainfall in Sabtang at 6 a.m. this morning. Cagayan is still under signal number 2 except for the towns of Santa Ana and Babuyan Group of Islands, which are under signal number 3, while the Batanes Group of Islands is under signal number 4. PJ Cabanos, ABS-CBN News. Back to you, Carmina.
Yeah, PJ, just a couple of questions for you before we let you go. Where is Cagayan now in terms of the planting cycle? Do we expect heavy damage in terms of agriculture, PJ?
Actually, Carmina, we don't have received a report yet from the Cagayan Provincial Disaster Reduction Office. Mm-mm. So I don't have any update for that, Carmina.
All right. We continue to monitor the situation in Cagayan there. Thanks again for joining us. PJ Cabanos there, our correspondent covering Cagayan.